Greetings, my dear brothers and sisters in the Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome to this program called Freedom. I'm sure you are truly experiencing the freedom in the Spirit, freedom in the Lord, freedom in many things. God has been setting many of us free from many bondages, and He's also side by side equipping you to set many free. So welcome again. Today we will be dealing with prophetic dreams and visions. As we are living in these end times, God is pouring out the Spirit. As a result, many prophetic dreams and visions are being shown to many of you. We are going to deal with one episode from the Bible where the prophetic dream came to Joseph and how Joseph was blessed. That passage is in Matthew chapter 1, verse 18, the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. Joseph was betrothed to Mary, and before they came together, they found to be with a child. Mary was pregnant. And Joseph was secretly contemplating to divorce Mary quietly. When he almost decided that night, an angel of the Lord appears to Joseph in a dream and tells Joseph, "Joseph, do not divorce Mary, because what is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. So take her back." Joseph wakes up from the sleep and then changes his decision and gets married to Mary according to the prophetic dream. But of course, they did not have any sexual union until Jesus, our Lord, was born. That was the story in Matthew chapter 1, verse 18 to 25. So I'm going to speak to you about prophetic dreams and the visions. When heaven decides about the beloved Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, and His birth, and He orchestrates, heaven orchestrates every details on earth, how things has to take place, who are the characters, and the place, timing, every detail. Heaven dictate terms on earth. And heaven is also climaxes certain stories which seems to be negative for Joseph. He almost deciding to divorce Mary. Oh, and that's the time heaven intervenes into the affairs of Joseph and Mary. One of the things of heaven which we must remember is that heaven has all authority in heaven, earth, under the earth. So, heaven dictates term. We pray that prayer in the Lord's Prayer, right? Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So, heaven orchestrates everything. That brings us to the first point, orchestrations. Orchestrations. Prophetic dreams are orchestrations of heaven. Prophetic dreams are orchestrations from heaven, verse 20 of Matthew chapter 1. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit." Joseph thought to divorce Mary quietly, but heaven had a different plan about it altogether. Oh yes, many can secretly plan, secretly think, secretly contemplate, be it negative or positive. When it is negative against heaven's plans, sometimes God orchestrate and intervenes in a very powerful way, because that's the orchestration of God, that Son of God has to come into this world to through Virgin Mary in order to give us life as a ransom for the mankind to be saved. And that is the orchestration of God. How will heaven lose in that sense when Joseph tried to get away from heaven's plan? Oh yes, impossible. Joseph, that's where God's orchestration comes into play. Remember Magi, when they had a secret deal with Herod in Matthew chapter 2, after this episode. They're supposed to come back to Herod after worshipping the newborn King Jesus. But that night, heaven orchestrated a different plan altogether. And an angel of the Lord comes to the Magi, the wise men, and bring about a prophetic dream. What is the dream? Don't go back to Herod, because he is going to assassinate you and the newborn king. Oh yes, how heaven orchestrate in order to protect you and I. May God orchestrate things in your life as he orchestrated for Joseph. May God orchestrate heaven's plan in your life, especially when you contemplate, when you're secretly thinking about foregoing because certain things that is not acceptable to you. May God orchestrate his plan, heaven's plan for your life today. My dear young person, are you contemplating, knowing fully well that this is the will of God, but you are going to run away from it? No, don't do it. Number two, not only prophetic dreams are orchestrations from heaven, prophetic dreams are interruptions from heaven too. Prophetic dreams can interfere, interrupt in the man's affairs. Oh yes, in some cases, heaven's interruptions are very severe and very dangerous situations where God interferes and intervenes. Recently, one of my spiritual daughter was sharing with me the dream that she had about one of her contacts. And that person attempted suicide with burnt injuries, admitted in the hospital. This daughter of mine, she was a little scary about demonic things. Just prior to that, couple of weeks ago, I was taking a Bible study on demonic oppressions and how to set captives free. So she was sharing with me how an angel of the Lord appeared to her in a dream and how she saw her contact with the burnt injuries. It was the work of demons. And she saw how the demons overpowered that girl and how strangled her and made her to contemplate or commit that suicidal act. And she saw the demons trying to take that person's life. And this daughter of mine, seeing in a dream, setting the demons out from that girl and then setting that girl free from that suicidal spirit, which she was scared to do in the physical realm. But in the dream she saw, she was setting her contact free from that suicidal spirit. The next day when she called her up, that girl was admitted in the hospital. She was getting better and her mind was released supernaturally, because things in the dream was dealt. There are things that God interrupts in somebody else's life because the demons are at work. That's exactly what we are speaking about in these end times. That prophetic dreams where you don't need to do sometimes certain things, but in the dreams, God can bring about that kind of interruptions where the demons are at work. May God set peoples free. May there be prophetic dreams. Say Amen. Yes, God is in the process of intercepting, intervening, giving prophetic dreams, which will set captives free too. So orchestrations of God, interruptions of God, especially when we go against the will of God. Thirdly, manifestations. Prophetic dreams are manifestations of heaven. Heaven is in charge, not the earth, not even underneath the earth. We call that hell. Heaven wants to manifest its power, especially when it comes to His Son, Jesus Christ the Lord. How will heaven permit to go anything against the Son of God and the plan about the Son of God and the purposes of the Son of God birthing into this earth? Impossible. Heaven is always victorious. Say with me, heaven, our God, is always victorious. Oh yes, the manifestations of God through the supernatural or prophetic dreams and visions. How in the Old Testament Joseph had dreams and vision, and how his brothers and family has to come and bow before him one day. But that did not happen overnight. Things came against that prophetic dream. Many a times things will come against the plan of God in our lives, knowing that is the perfect will of God. The enemies are not going to keep quiet. Satan is not going to keep quiet. When that is the perfect will of God, that is going to bring about a result which is going to be enormous, supernatural magnitude effect. And the enemy somehow comes to know, and he's not going to keep quiet. So Joseph had a prophetic dream, but the enemy came against time and again, time and again. His brothers contemplated, you remember? Joseph's father sending him to find out about his brothers, and he's walking into that forest all alone. And from far, the brothers recognizing Joseph approaching them, and they contemplated to kill Joseph. Oh yes, they put him in that pit where there was no water, thinking that Joseph will die. Never. Prophetic dream will never die. And the hero in that prophetic dream will not go without a fight. And that pit experience Joseph overcame. And then he ends up in Egypt. There another thing comes against Joseph while he was minding his own business. Because somebody else is not minding her business, but trying to mind somebody else's business, Joseph's business. She came against Joseph. I'm talking about Potiphar's wife. And you know what has happened. And Joseph had to run away from that scene, only to end up in the prison. There God was with Joseph. Oh yes, in every situation, if you carry prophetic mantle, if you carry prophetic dream, God will work with you. And so Joseph was in the prison. There he interprets the dream to one of the two guys. In fact, two people from the king's place. And you know the story, how they forget. Finally, with all that he has gone through, with all the enemy that thrown things against Joseph, finally, everybody say finally. Finally, Joseph won. The prophetic dream came into existence, manifestation. In these times, God is bringing to fulfillment the prophetic dreams, prophetic things that He has spoken over many lives. We are in that season, the season of revival. And then Jesus, our Lord, is going to return anytime. And this is the exciting times that we are living in. May your dreams be prophetic. May your visions be prophetic. May there be manifestations of God. So orchestrations of God, interruptions of God, manifestations of God. Fourthly and finally, interconnections of God. Prophetic dream would be in line with prophetic word. Prophetic dream would be in line with the prophetic word. You see, God spoke to Mother Mary separately, and God is speaking to Joseph separately. God sending his angel Gabriel to bring about the prophetic news for Mary. At the same time, God sending a prophetic dream and talking to Joseph. These two are two incidences, but interconnected. How God bringing that interconnections when it is heaven's plan and heaven's will in those dear ones' life. What was spoken to Mary is the same which was shown to Joseph in a dream prophetically. It was matching with one another. The prophetic word to Mary and the prophetic dream to Joseph. So for both, it is interconnecting. I remember a servant of God was asked to go to a different country to do a ministry. This man of God was praying, Lord, you have given me this word to go to such and such country to do such and such ministry. I am ready. But the people where I'm going to minister to, they also need to be told by you that you are sending me to them. So he was sure of his calling and the leading of God prophetically to go to another country and to do that ministry. Lo and behold, when this servant of God went there, he found out through the mouth of his own people saying, God sent a prophet some time ago and gave all the specifications about you, that you should be coming and ministering in this place. How that was matching? Without this man of God telling them, and God already spoken to them through the prophetic voice, through a prophet, interconnections. Interconnections that we are talking about. So God brings that connections together when heaven orchestrates it. Beautiful. Beautiful. There are many, many stories of how God supernaturally bringing those interconnections. How wonderful that is. How wonderful our God is. Oh, may God, may heaven give you dreams and visions that is orchestrated by God, that is going to be manifested by God, and that God will bring about that interconnection so that you will know for sure 100%, this is the plan of God. This is the will of God. This is what I am born to do in this world, in this time. May God give you that kind of assurance, interconnections and manifestations, if needed, interruptions to stop you from not doing the will of God. Oh yes, that is what God is up to in these end times. Devil is going to be defeated. Hell's plan is going to be defeated. Man's plan is going to be defeated. God's plan is going to bring into fulfillment. Say amen. Yes, in many lives where I see young people, if you are hooking up with something where God is not in it, may God interrupt in that plan and break that thing out of you and bring about heaven's connections to you. That is so peaceful and wonderful, because every one of us one day going to stand before God, and all of us are going to be asked one question. What have you done on earth? Have we done the will of God perfectly? The plan of God in this world. God has created you for a purpose. My young dear brother, my young dear sister, God has created you for a purpose. You have one life to live. What you have done for God according to the plan and the will of God, that will last for eternity. Everything else is going to be destroyed. I challenge you today to allow God to intervene. I see a family. Your young boy, is rebellion. He is not listening to you. You know what he is doing is not of God. You're praying that God will intervene in his life. This is the word that coming to you, dear parents. That boy will be intercepted very soon. He will be intercepted and he is going to disconnect by his own, supernaturally by God. And he will come and submit to heaven's plan through you. And you will rejoice and you will testify that my boy finally, accepted the will of God. And we are rejoicing with God. Oh, may that testimony arise. May God bring about that kind of manifestation, interceptions, and interconnections, wherever that is. You are praying for your daughter for a good marriage proposal. God will bring a godly boy to your home. You will not go in search of the boy, but the boy will come in search of your girl. Oh, yes, that's a word for somebody. Receive it. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you, thank you, thank you for the prophetic dreams and visions. You are interfering in man's businesses, never before in the history. Oh yes, never before in the history. God is invading, intercepting, interrupting many plans of man and bringing about the purposes of God. Hallelujah. Evil's plans are broken over the church in the name of Jesus. Every demonic plans are broken over that family. Oh, God's plan, God's will, God's peace is flooding right now through this word. Receive that peace. Receive that miracle. Receive the will of God. God is opening somebody's eyes to see the plan of heaven right now coming into fulfillment. You will witness heaven's plan. Yes. Hallelujah. 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 Soak in that presence of God. Soak in that anointing of God. God is at work in intercepting, in manifesting, in interconnecting, because all these things are the orchestration of God. His word will never fail in your life and your family. And I seal that. Rejoice together and begin to give thanks. Thank you, Jesus, O God, for your love and kindness, for intervening, intercepting, interrupting in the lives of people. Love you, Jesus. We honor you. We give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. May God bless you, my dear brother and sister. I'm sure you're blessed by this program. Please write to the address that you see on the screen. See you next time. Until then, may God's power overpower you, overshadow you, bless you.
Freedom and Restoration Ministries, Flat 202 Bello Arcade, 1B Main Road, AVC Extension, Horamavu, Bengaluru. Email address joelrkr@gmail.com.